A family affair. That's how Press Secretary Angeles described the 93rd birthday party of former First Lady Imelda Marcos at the Malacañang Palace Saturday. Imelda's grandson, Michael Manotok, posted photos of the event on his public Instagram profile. It appeared the party took place at the Rizal Hall, which is usually used for state dinners and other assemblies. Ilocos Norte Representative Angelo Marcos Barba also posted photos from the event. Those posts quickly earned the ire of social media users and critics of the Marcos family, who believe lavish parties will once again be a usual event at the palace.
It was a family affair, and so I don't know if a policy will be born out of this one, but we certainly will note that observation. We assure you that the president will adhere to law. Mm-hmm. And so that is the presumption. The president has made no directive in excess of anything that is written in the law.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. buckles down to work as he begins his first full week in office. He attended his first flag-raising ceremony in Malacañang Monday morning. It was followed by a short speech where Marcos urged his staff to do well in performing their duties to the Filipino people. He added he hopes for a good working relationship with them as he reiterated his message of unity. After the flag-raising ceremony, Marcos went to the Department of Agriculture office in Quezon City to officially begin his work as head of the agency. There are no details yet on how the meeting with DA officials went. Interior and Local Government Secretary Benhur Abalos Jr. also listing his priorities for his first 100 days in office. These include the efficient implementation of the Mandanas ruling, the fast-tracking of over 2,000 pending local government permits to build telecommunication towers, and jail decongestion. Abalos, who will be heading the police force, also vowed to continue the Duterte administration's bloody war on drugs.
The war against drugs will be as intensive as before, on the basis on my oath as a public official in accordance with the Constitution. Of course, we will get rid of the scalawags. No, kailangan mawala ang scalawags. Pero kung konting porsyento yan eh. Marami tayong magagaling na police. Marami po yan. Ayaw natin yung maliit na porsyento na ay masira. No? But what is important, itong nakaharap sa drug war ay mamotivate naman natin. Kawawa naman kung babalikan ng mga malaking sindikato.
Social Welfare Secretary Erwin Tulfo announces the start of a cash subsidy program for poor families in his first flag-raising ceremony as DSWD chief. Tulfo assured families listed under the targeted cash assistance program they will receive 500 pesos per month. He also orders the agency to begin storing up enough food packs and relief items in anticipation of calamities.
Ngayong araw din po, inaatasan ko si Disaster Undersecretary Marco Bautista na muling umpisahan ang prepositioning o maagang paglalagay ng mga food packs at relief items sa mga lugar na madalas dinadaanan ng bagyo, mga lugar na binabaha, at mga nagkaka-landslide para bago pa man tumama ang kalamidad o diluvyo sa mga naturang lugar ay naroon na po ang tulong ng pamahalaan.
Justice Secretary Boying Remulla also attending his first flag-raising ceremony at the agency. In a speech, Remulla vowed to go after syndicates in three key agencies under his department: the Land Registration Authority, the Bureau of Immigration, and the Bureau of Corrections. Transport Secretary Jaime Bautista sets his sights on addressing commuting problems in the Philippines. He discussed plans with transport regulators on how to alleviate the plight of the riding public. That's after he attended the flag-raising ceremony and changing of guards at the Land Transportation Franchising and Regulatory Board. During the meeting, he also said he will need to study whether to retain or tweak government's free ride program. Last week, President Marcos extended the free rides at the EDSA carousel until December. He also approved free train rides for students when classes resume in August.